Oh man, so another Anthony Davis video. I ain't gonna lie, for the next like week or so, this is probably the only topic I'm really on. I might talk about other stuff because trade deadline is coming up really, really soon. But I'm sorry, there's nothing more exciting right now than this. This is the most exciting news that you could get on the block. Anthony Davis right now, that's it. And what's crazy right now is that he actually got fined $50,000 because of the whole coming out public about the trade requests and all that stuff. But there's a lot of stuff going on right now, okay? Basically, the Pelicans have made their whole team available now for trade talks, okay? A lot of good players, actually, that I think should be looked at. All teams in the NBA have made their teams basically all available except, like, their main stars, and they're all available, okay? One of these teams being the Bucks. You know, the whole team, it's available. You can have everything except Giannis, and we want just Anthony Davis, right? So that's happening. The Pelicans also put out a statement. And the Pelicans put out a statement talking about how, you know, this is happening. This is a thing. We are aware of this. We are going to make a move on our time and, you know, this and that. But they also included a statement to make sure, hey, NBA, we don't like this. You know, check out the tampering rules. And then later on, what happens? Anthony Davis did get fined because the NBA did investigate that situation. And, I mean, obviously, $50,000. It is a lot of money. It's like a lot more than I'm making a year. A lot more, right? So Anthony Davis has to pay that up, but he already has that, so that's all good. But that's beyond the fact. It's just the fact that, you know, this is a weird situation. And I really wonder, like, what's going on with everybody, right? Because Drew Holiday, he had a statement as well saying, you know, part of the reason I'm still here is because of Anthony Davis, you know? And I guess what I'm really trying to say is, like, how do they all feel now, you know? And, you know, they got to be professional about this. And I think Anthony Davis, if those are really his boys, he already discussed this with them. They're aware. I hope they're aware beforehand. You know, if anybody didn't learn from the Russell Westbrook, Kevin Durant situation. And, I mean, honestly, Anthony Davis is a grown man. And those men there, even though they are a team and Anthony Davis is the number one guy and he's just going to leave, up and leave, they're all grown men. I mean, he wants to make a move for him, you know? And I'm not saying that that makes every situation right. I'm not saying that. As a player, I'm not really tripping on if you leave. I'm tripping on how you leave, the circumstances of where you're leaving. Leaving is leaving. It's like, you know, you make your move. But it's all about the circumstances of where this team has put you, how you've been treated. Like, that's why I look at the Kevin Durant situation very differently. I really don't want to talk about it too hard because I'm over all that and I'm not trying to bring negative connotations to all that. But that situation versus this is a whole different thing. Kevin Durant was in a whole winning situation. He had a chance for championships. It was even, you know, essentially. And he made it uneven. Anthony Davis is being put in a situation where, you know, he's really tried and he had a chance and it was kind of even a little bit, or at least the hope of it being even with adding DeMarcus Cousins really probably brought hope. And then that got crushed and then he still tried and now he's still putting up career numbers and it's just things are not working out. It's not working. Now, do I 100% think he's going to Lakers? No. So that's why I'm optimistic because, you know, wherever he goes, he could really change things. And I've said this already in almost all the videos, but that's the most exciting thing about it. That's why it's so huge, because he could literally change things. Like, whatever team he goes to, even the Pelicans, for that matter, are a changed team. They get some players back. They may be still competitive because they may get some young talent, some picks. And they still got guys that maybe this trade does make them better because it's maybe quantity over quality in this situation when it should really be quality over quantity. But they can get more depth and essentially they could be better. And then next thing you know, they could start making some things happen maybe for an eighth seed. You know, I'm just, you know, trying to be optimistic for them. But as for Anthony Davis, he gets to be on a whole new situation, winning, possibly going for a championship. And he's so young that this is his legacy right here. This is where, wherever he goes, I think this is where more eyes are on him, more pressure is on him, and all that. And that's where we see how he performs. And I'm excited for that part, okay? I want to see from this next team what happens, because if he gets put in a winning situation, I think things for him as a player just change. So tell me what you guys think down below. Screw this 50,000 fine. He's not even tripping. He's trying to make bigger things happen. So if you guys enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe for more. I'm out.